the last few years, there was a lack of a great level of analysis of the hegemonic masculinity. There was a need to raise the awareness of the stereotype of the Australian society and mentioning the marginalisation of particular masculine groups, the illusion of an ideal type of man portrayed in the media.
I guess the biggest stereotype I see of men in Australia would have to be maybe that surfer guy, so the blonde hair, maybe Anglo white kind of looking guy.
Traditionally, whether it's relevant now, even in the media, I suppose it's kind of been, you know, tall, bronze, 6 foot, etc.
They all sort of masculine, very athletic, go to the gym after work. Basically, they're just tough. I would say no, because in the media they all sort of can handle their situation. They sort of don't have to deal with a lot of problems.
My father's Filipino, so I don't think he fits that stereotypical kind of Aussie bloke. But when I do look at like my uncles, for example, they like cars, they like going to the beach, they all live in like coastal kind of houses near the water. So I feel like they would fit that kind of stereotype.
Especially with sort of the advent of the internet and stuff. Like, it's very easy to find somebody that you can relate to, I guess, just because there's such that incredible wealth of sort of resources and stuff.
No, they're very underrepresented and they're very marginalised as well.
When it comes to, I guess, TV shows like Home and Away and that kind of thing, it's dominantly like a very Anglo-Saxon white kind of cast. But when you can look at things such as reality TV shows, you do see an integration of people from, I guess, other kinds of cultures, so different kinds of like masculinities represented, but not in the majority of media.
So what does this impose on men of other masculinities? This is a question in need of answer to alleviate not only the burden of marginalising stereotypes on men, but also that on women. We need your help to fuel conversation, flow of ideas, and then develop these by and into communities through appropriate discussion, survey, and collection of data.